Okay, hello everyone. One moment. So happy Monday. Let me share first our Spanish tutorial. So that we can have hello, mega shout out, Jovelyn Dagan. Hi, hello, Jovelyn. I am thinking actually, okay, so I put my this is actually my personal reviewer on my wall. Hola, maestra. Buenas noches. Buenos días desde España, Jovelyn Dagan. So I get this what they call this one, visual aid for you, especially for you, because I remembered last time you asked me to have a future tense. So today we are going to discuss about siguro isa lang muna kasi baka mas malito kapag lahatin na natin. So we will just discuss maybe one, for example, indefinido or imperfecto or yung dalawa after nung isa. No? So, but let me share. Please share it to your social media account also. Ayos na ayos po yan para sa amin po. Salamat mo. Upo, effort talaga si ano, di ba? Effort ako. Kasi alam niyo, natutuwa kasi ako na nandyan kayo na sinasamahan niyo ako sa aking live streaming. So anyway, give me 1 minute to share our tutorial today so that we can have more people. Okay, so if you have also a social media account, please share it. Please share it. 1 moment. Okay, we will share it too so that we have more people inside. Okay. 1 moment. But anyway, so how are you guys? Isidro Galdores, Feliz Año Nuevo, Miss Cat. Feliz Año Nuevo! Happy New Year! Isidro Galdores, thank you a lot. Feliz Año Nuevo. Hoy, el día 4, el 6 de enero aquí es muy importante para los niños. Hindi pa tapos ang Christmas sa Spanish kapag hindi pa tapos ang Three Kings. That is the most awaited date for the children. It's nice to be back, attend your class. Oh, thank you so much. Muchísimas gracias por unirte a mi canal. Isidro desde Ibiza. ¿Es correcto? Tama po ba ang aking ano, memory, si Isidro? You are from Ibiza, right? Ibiza, Spain. Ibiza, Spain is like Boracay and the Philippines. 1 moment, please. I will just share it so that we can have more people inside, okay? I'm sorry. 1 moment. Group. Share to a group. Okay, so as you can see on the board, I listed Denada, si Miss Cat, Ibiza ako. Wow, I wish I can visit Ibiza, the famous Ibiza in the in Spain. I will just okay. We are going to share it. So that we can have more viewers in our tutorial today. So I really tried to have our Spanish tutorial while I am having my vacation because on the 7th of January, I will be back to academy. So definitely, I don't have more time for you guys, but I really try to make time for you. Bahala na, pinindot ko na lang yung ano eh. Basta lang ma-share natin ba? Okay. Share lang natin. Malay mo, dumami pa ang ating subscribers. Okay. So, ayan, we're going to start now. Please do not forget to like. Give me a thumbs up. So, yun, give me a thumbs up. Okay. So, today, we are going actually to discuss about future tense. Okay, so we're going to talk about a future past tense rather. My God, nalito na naman sila. Okay, so ito actually ay personal ano ko to. Personal ko tong reviewer nung ako ay nag-aaral pa. Last year ko pa to gawa tong ano ko. Calendar actually to. Recycle is life. Baby Natalia and Philip, new here. Hi, Baby Natalia. Thank you so much for joining my live streaming. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to my channel. I am hoping that you are going to help me to grow my channel so that we can have more people in this tutorial. By the way, okay, so this list actually, are you all Filipino? Would you mind if I'm going to speak English or would you like me to speak Tagalog? Ano po, na ako po yung mag-a-adjust. Well, ako po yung mag-a-adjust. Thanks a lot. Ayan. So these are my reviewer actually. I posted this on my wall last year para napapractice ko so that I can practice present, presente, indefinido, imperfecto, futuro. So this is actually a recycled material because this is a calendar. Look. Okay. So, anyways, since we don't have a budget, so we will just find ways. Yeah, we will just find ways. Thank you so much for the 7,000 in the house. And don't forget to give a thumbs up on my live streaming. Okay, so as you can see, on the first row, we have the present tense, el presente. So, our example is verbo trabajar. Okay? So, as you can see, yo trabajo. For example, no? Yo trabajo cada día. Presente. Tú trabajas cada día. For example, second person, trabajas. Third person, trabaja cada día. Trabaja cada día. So, yo, tú, él, ella, o usted. Vale, hindi ko na sinulat yung ano ha, pronombres personales. Hola, hola, Easy Money. Muchísimas gracias por unirte a mi canal. If you have any comments, suggestions, opinions about our topic, just feel free to chat, okay? If you want me to write the pronoun, the personal pronouns o pronombres personales, or alam niyo na yon. So, ito na yung ano. ¿Va? Nosotros trabajamos, for example, ¿no? Nosotros trabajamos cada día. Okay? We are working every day. ¿Trabajáis? ¿Vosotros trabajáis? Okay? ¿Trabajáis es para vosotros? One moment. ¿Trabajáis? Hindi na naman siya lumalabas. Okay. Trabajáis. And then, ellos, ellas, ustedes trabajan. So, this is our present verbs. Okay? So, going to first person, second person, third person, singular. First person, plural. Second person, plural. And third person, plural. Ayan. Kasi big in the Philippines, we only have the word trabaho. Ako ay nagtatrabaho. Siya ay nagtatrabaho. Yun lang, sa Spanish kasi, iba-iba yung verb nila. As you can see, first person, trabaho. And then second person, another verb. Third person, another verb. Okay, so indefinido. So indefinido and imperfecto, itong dalawa na to, these two are in past tense. Bale? So, ano yung difference nila? What are the difference between indefinido and imperfecto? So, anoche, okay? Ayer, last night, yesterday, ayer, anteayer, a day before yesterday. Ano ba yan sa Tagalog? Anteayer. Ano ba sa Tagalog ang anteayer? Otro dia is Espanyol. Antes de yesterday. Hola. Okay, so, el otro día, the other day, la semana pasada, okay, last week, pasada kasi, because semana is femenino, so that is why pasada, okay? And then, hace una semana, el mes, or año pasado, el año, porque es masculino, pasado. Semana es femenino, pasada. Ok, so, el año pasado, o el mes, ¿vale? Pasado. And then, imperfecto, ay no, dito muna tayo. Trabajé, for example, trabajé. Indefinido is like a past simple sa English. Past simple. Indefinido para contar el pasado. Okay? So, the meaning of indefinido para contar el pasado, con el indefinido nos colocamos después de un hecho pasado y contamos un acto o un proceso terminado. So, meaning, tapos na po na nangyari ang action. Okay? So, el indefinido presenta ese proceso como ya terminado en aquel momento del pasado. Cuenta un hecho completo. So, for example, trabajé. Ayan, mahalaga po yung acento. Kasi makikita nyo yung pagkakaiba ng tenses of verbs. Kaya it's very important na alam din po yung accent. Okay? And then, next. Trabajaste. So, from present, the word trabajas in past, trabajaste. Okay? For example, la semana pasada, trabajaste. Okay? Because we're talking about past. Trabajo. Trabajo. Okay? Trabajo. And then, from the word trabaja, el pasado, trabajo. Okay? Third person. Trabajamos, look at that one, and then it's the same. Trabajamos. Wait lang. Let me check if hindi ba ako nagkamali sa pagsulat ng ating check natin sa ating mahiwagang libro. Trabajar, verbo trabajar. Sí, it's the same. Trabajamos. It's the same. Akala ko ano, nagkamali ako. Trabajamos. One moment.
A moment like this. Hindi siya talaga lumalabas.
Okay, so as you can see in the present and in the past tense, it's the same. Trabajamos, trabajamos. And then, vosotros, el pasado. Trabajasteis, trabajasteis. Okay? And then, ellos, ellas, ustedes, el pasado, trabajaron. Okay? Por ejemplo, el año pasado, ellos trabajaron en España, for example. ¿No? Ellos trabajaron. Okay? And then, imperfecto, pasado. Okay. Antes, todos los días, siempre, y cuando era. Cuando era. So, ito yung mga markadores, parang ano ba sa atin? Paano ba yan natin tawagin? Ano, parang palatandaan sa Tagalog na ano yan? Ah, indefinido pala pagka may mga ganitong ano, anoche, ayer. Tapos, imperfecto, ano siya, kapag may antes, means before, todos los días, every day, and then siempre is always, and then cuando era, when, no? Cuando era is when. So, as you can see, nakita niyo po yung pagkakaiba nila, yung from trabajo, trabaje, and then trabajaba. Trabajaba in Filipinas. Ibig sabihin, nagtrabaho ako dati sa Pilipinas. Estaba yo. Estaba is otro verbo. Trabajaba in for example, trabajaba in Las Piñas Science National High School in Filipinas. Trabajaba. Una person. Ay, first person. Okay? So, if you have any questions, comments, suggestions, feel free po na magsulat po sa ating live chat, okay? Tiyagain lang po muna natin ha, kasi kailangan talaga ano, makita niya yung difference bago natin i-ano ba, kasi pagka bago pa lang tayong nag-aaral, medyo mahirap. Parameters po ba, reminders ata, maestra? Reminders. Okay? So, ayan. From, trabajas, trabajaste, trabajabas. Okay? Trabajabas. Okay? Trabajabas. And then, third person, trabajaba. Trabajaba. So, kung napansin niyo po, in-underline ko, ayan yung mga palatandaan na i-ano nyo pagka paano kayo nagpapalit ng panauhan sa, I mean, from the root word na trabaho. Tapos ayan, aba, abas, aba. And then, trabaha, trabajabamos. Trabajabamos. And dito yung accent sa a, sa ha. Trabajabamos. Okay? And then, trabajabais and trabajaban. Trabajaban. Okay? Ayan. Trabajaban. So, ano muna natin yan? Para lang ipinakita ko lang sa inyo kung ano yung pagkakaiba ng bawat berbo sa bawat panahon. I mean, yung tenses of verbs. From present to past, past, and then future, nakikita nyo dito, iba din yung, ano, iba na din yung mga verb nila pagdating sa future. From trabajo, trabajo to trabajare. For example, trabajare en hoy es lunes, en jueves. Trabajare en jueves por la mañana. Okay, futuro. Trabajarás mañana. Trabajarás mañana. Trabajará. Trabajará. And then, trabajaremos. Trabajaremos. And trabajaréis. And trabajarán. Trabajarán. Okay? So, ayan po, idinikit ko po para talaga makita nyo yung pagkakaiba po ng bawat berbo. So, para sa akin ha, ito kasi yung ano, ito kasi yung ginawa ko para, kasi nung dumating ako dito nung 2018 of June, hindi, wala talaga akong alam na Spanish. Ang alam ko lang hola. Hindi ako nakakapag-communicate. So, anong ginawa ko? Every day, naglilist ako ng verbs. Tsaka yung ano talaga, yung pronoun. Yun ang ano, yun ang pinaka inuna ko, yung pronouns. Yo, estoy, tú, estás, paisa-isa. Tapos every day yan, inaano ko siya. Minememorize ko siya. Kasi magkakaiba nga ang bawat panauhan nila. Diba? Tapos, ngayon, makakabuo ka na ng sentences kapag madami ka ng alam na vocabulary sa Spanish. Kasi kung hindi mo panaiintindihan ang lahat ng salita nila, mahirap gumawa ng sentence. So, if you are a beginner, it is really normal na ginagawa mo pa isa-isa. For me ha, each word, like nililista ko lahat ng verbs. Tapos, if I do not understand that verb, I will translate that in English or in Tagalog. Kung ano man yung mas madali mong naiintindihan, English ba, Tagalog ba, o Bisaya ba, o kung ano man yung lingwahe na mas madali mo siyang maintindihan. Ngayon, kapag alam mo na to pa isa-isa, ba, doon ka mag-start sa yo trabajo, di ba? Tu trabajas, tal, tal, tal. And then, mag-start ka ng pronoun and then the verbs. Tapos, yung mga vocabulary na alam mo na, ayan, may noun ka na alam, meron ka ng adjective na alam, diba? Alam mo na yung mga salita, estoy triste, estoy contenta, halimbawa. So, makakabuo ka na ng sentence, diba? Hindi yung, for example, sentence agad, tapos yung buong sentence, hindi mo siya naiintindihan. So, mas mahirap. Kaya, ganun yung ano, kaya minsan, diba, nag-share ako ng vocabulary kasi talaga, mas marami kang alam na vocabulary, mas madali kang makakapag-communicate. Kasi paano ka makikipag-communicate kung wala kang alam masyado na vocabulary? Kasi yun naman ang importante. Oh my God, another disruption. Lobat tayo. Kailangan kong kunin yung charger. Saglit lang po, Ayan, ano lang naman. Andito lang sa ano ko. Sa tabi ko. Saglit lang. Naku, pasensya na kayo, ha? Alam niyo naman tayo. Okay. Normally, nire-ready ko to eh. Nakalimutan ko siya kanina. Hindi po. Hindi sa imperfecto. Kasi, Yung indefinido, ano siya, past simple. Ang imperfecto kasi ay parang, paano ko ba explain? Ang imperfecto ay para siyang continuous action. Jovelin. Imperfecto. Cuando bajaba, for example, no? El niño dormió toda la noche. Tranquilo. Ayan. Sa bagay, ang continuo kasi mag-a-ing tayo, pero yo estaba trabajando. Yo estaba trabajando. So, ang verb natin doon ay estar. One moment. Nag-chat yung aking. Dime. No, estaba yo en directo ahora, cariño. Vale. Okay. Vale. Pues adiós. Hi. Sorry, ang daming ano eh, ang daming patalastas, Diyos ko naman. Okay, so, hindi po, magkaiba po yung imperfecto at yung indefinido, Jovelin. Magkaiba po silang dalawa. Magkaiba silang dalawa. Yun po ba yung ano nyo? Both verbs po ba sa imperfecto? Hindi, magkaiba po ang indefinido at yung imperfecto. Okay, ano yung pinagkaiba nila? Ang imperfecto para describir el pasado. Imperfecto para describir el pasado. So, for example, con el imperfecto nos colocamos dentro de un hecho pasado y describimos un proceso no terminado. Pasado siya pero hindi pa siya tapos. Yun yung imperfecto. Ang indefinido kasi, talagang tapos na siya. So, ano yung difference nila? Yung imperfecto kasi, ano siya? Describe una sitwasyon momentanea. When you are describing in the moment. Yung imperfecto. Yun yung pinagkaiba ng imperfecto sa indefinido. Yan yung pagkakaiba ng dalawa. Okay? Jovelin? So, magawa tayo ng ano? Magawa tayo ng, anong tawag nito? Mga sentences. Pakita natin yung difference ng dalawa. Okay? So, ito, pinakita ko lang sa inyo yung pagkakaiba. Ayan, nakita nyo yung pagkakaiba ng present sa past at sa, I mean, sa simple past at sa imperfecto. Ayan, vivo, vivi, vivia, vivere. Ang futuro, vivere. Vives, viviste, vivias, viveras. And then, vive, vivió, vivía, vivira, vivimos, vivimos, vivíamos, and viveremos. Vivís, vivisteis, vivías, viviréis, viven, vivieron, vivían, and vivían. Ayan, Ano, gawa tayo ng ano? Gawa tayo ng sentences. Yeah. Ano natin? Oh, di ba? Para-paraan lang tayo sa ating ano, di ba? Sa ating tutorial class. Magawa tayo ng sentence. Ay, sana pala hindi ko tinanggal yung ano. Para makita nyo yung... Okay. So, for example, one moment ha, sulat lang ako ng ilang bawa. El Niño. Toda la noche. Okay, so for example, this sentence, el niño durmió toda la noche muy tranquilo. Okay, so kung inyo pong napansin, third person ang pinag-uusapan natin. Tercera persona, el niño dormió, ¿vale? Toda la noche. Ayan, kung napansin nyo po yung marcadores natin, de ba? Doon sa indefinido, anoche. So, el niño dormió toda la noche. La noche, porque noche es femenino. So, our article is la. La noche. Muy tranquilo. Ibig sabihin, ano, ang bata ay natulog, no? Tama ba? Ang bata ay natulog buong gabi tahimik is tranquil, paano ba sa Tagalog yan? Nalito na sa pag-translate ng Tagalog eh. El niño durmió toda la noche muy tranquilo. So, third person po. Kaya ang verb natin dito, durmió. Ayan. Third person. Bale? So, halimbawa, ano bang ano natin? Ibang sentence natin. A moment like this. Ay, Oviedo. Mucho. Hoy. So, for example, llovido mucho hoy. So, pag ganawin natin yan ng ano, llovió, Diba? Yubyo. Mucho. Yubyo mucho. Ano tayo? Imperfecto. Cuando? Gawa tayo ng ano, para makita niyo yung difference. Cuando? Cuando bajo? Las escaleras? Cuando bajó las escaleras, se, third person, encontró. Si encontró un sapo, si encontró. Oh, ano bang gusto niyo makita sa hagdanan? Cuando bajó, de ba, yung imperfecto, may marcadores tayo na cuando. Cuando. Bajó, tapos a third person, and encontró, third person, yung ginamit natin dyan, verb. Bajó, encontró, verbo bajar, going down, bajar. Pababa ng hagdanan. Encontró, verbo encontrar, nakita. For example, nakita, may nakita ka sa hagdanan, no? El año pasado. Preterito indefinido. El año pasado. Naghanap ako ng ano, tawag yan. Tinitingnan ko yung mga printouts ko para mapakita ko sa inyo yung pagkakaiba nilang dalawa. Alam nyo, nagtataka ako dito. Bakit hindi ko nakikita yung ano ng ano natin? So, for example, verbo nacer, for example, no? So, in indefinido, nací. Nací el 20 de enero, for example, nací, indefinido. Nací. Ano natin? Ito yung sinasabi ko sa inyo na dapat pag nagganito tayo, nagagawa tayo ng sentences, madami na talaga dapat alam na words sa Spanish, words. Kasi pagka hindi, pag hindi po masyadong naiintindihan yung mga salita, mahirap siyang intindihin. Nasi, ano, first person. Yo nasi, for example, el día 20 de enero, for example, no? Ayan. Nasi el día 20 de enero. Verbo nacer. Pag gagawin mo yung second person, paano? Nasiste el día 20 de enero, for example. Tapos, pag third person, nasio. Tapos pag first person plural, nacimos. Nacimos, tapos nacéis, and then nacieron. Nacieron. So, yun yung, ano, yun yung pagkakaiba nilang dalawa. Okay po? Sige, i-touch natin yung ano, i-touch natin yung el pasado continuo. El pasado continuo. Ano natin? El pasado continuo. Vale. Mas madali kasi to eh. El pasado. So we are talking about past continuous. Okay, past continuous. So for example, yo estaba. So, we need a verb be, and that is was. I was working. Yo estaba trabajando. I was working. I was working. Yo estaba trabajando. Kung gusto mong sabihin yung ang tawag nito, sentence na to, ayan, ganyan mo siya i-translate sa English. I was working. Yo estaba trabajando. Tú estabas trabajando? No. Itim. Para makita niyo yung difference. Tú estabas. Ano tayo? Balik tayo sa basic. Doon mo tayo sa verb be. Sa verbo estar. Para hindi kayo masyadong matawag nito. Malito. You were working. Since ito yung mga ano eh, mga basic na sentence na madali nyong magamit. You were working. Él estaba trabajando. Él estaba Él estaba trabajando. He was working. So, pwede nyo yan i-ano. He, she, or it. Okay? Ello, estaba trabajando. It was working. Ello, it. Okay? And then, nosotros. Nosotras estábamos trabajando. Nosotros o nosotras estábamos trabajando. I just want you to look at the verbo estar en el pasado. Okay? Ano tayo? Doon tayo sa basic na sentence para mas madali yung maintindihan muna ito. Nosotros o nosotras estábamos trabajando. And then, vosotras estabais trabajando. Ellos, ellas, ustedes estaban ayan. Balik tayo sa verb be na pinaka simpleng ano ay hindi ko na translate ano ba yan? Sige, hayaan mo na lang. We were working, alam niyo na yan, 'di ba? You were working and they were working. Isa lang naman ito sa English, were lang naman 'to eh. Tagalog na ay Tagalog. El pasado ng are. Bale? Itong tatlo were. Were. So, ito at estaban. Were. They were working and so on. So, one moment. Hindi ko makita yung ano natin today. Ano ba yan? Nakakainis. Anyways, so, kung gusto nyo ng ano, ang past simple ng verb to be is past simple, again, past simple ng verb to be is I am. Kasi 'di ba I am I was el pasado, el presente am in el presente de español, Spanish is yo estoy trabajando. So yan yung magiging present continuous action natin. Estoy trabajando el presente, el pasado. Estaba trabajando. Then, second person, estabas trabajando. So, in present, sasabihin mo yan, estás trabajando, continuous action. Estás trabajando. Ngayon, pag ginawa natin yang indefinido, trabajé anoche, trabajé. And then, trabajaste, pero ang verb na ginamit ko na, trabajo na. Ito yung verb be na ginamit natin. Dito kasi yan yung tawag nito, madalas na ginagamit na magpakikipag-usap, yung verb be. Yan ang pinaka-basic na dapat alam mo talaga. Dapat memorize mo yung verbo estar at verbo ser. Kasi yan yung pinaka-importante sa lahat. I mean, the most important verb ever. Yan ang one and two sa list ko ng most common verb sa Spanish. One moment. Hindi ko alam bakit kanina ko pa sinisilip to. Hindi lumalabas yung ano natin. Hindi mo kumakita. So, ano yung mas madaling intindihin sa'yo? Jovelyn, are you still there? Ano ang mas madali mong intindihin na part ng past tense? Kasi ang pagkaiba lang naman ng indefinido at imperfecto, yung indefinido as in tapos na yung action. Tapos na talaga siya. Kumbaga, ano na, ang imperfecto kasi, parang, tawag nito, inesta momento mo lang siya inaano, dinidescribe. Parang ganun po yung pagkakaiba nila. Ay, salamat. Ayan kasi, ano bang tawag nito? Yan yung pinaka, paano ba? Ganyan ko siya inaral para mas madali kong maintindihan yung pagkakaiba ng mga past tense. I mean, how you are going to understand the different tenses in Spanish. Because if we are going to, like for example, we will do that as pro, as professional, hindi, mahirap natin siyang intindihin. Kasi hindi naman yan ang, kumbaga, kung nagsisimula pa lang tayo, di ba? If you are a beginner of studying the language, then we are go, it for me ha, mas maganda na sa basic tayo mag-start. Like for example, yung verbo estar, yan yung pinaka importante sa lahat. At verbo ser, 'di ba? Yung diniscuss ko naman na yung ano, yung difference nilang dalawa. Tapos ang indefinido kasi, kung alam mo na yung ano, alam mo na yung pattern, 'di ba? Yung pattern, madali mo na lang siyang intindihin na trabaje, trabajaste, trabajo, trabajamos, trabajasteis, at trabajaron. Yun na yung ano, yun na yung ano mo sa isip mo na, okay, first person ito yon, second person ito yon, third person ito yon. So, ganun, ano lang talaga, tiis-tiis lang. So, paano natin, ano tayo, gawa tayo ng mga example kung paano natin, paano ba, anong bang tawag nito? Paano natin siya anong tawag niyan? I-change each verb. Kapag verb, for example, verb that end with AR, ER, and IR. Para makita niyo yung difference. Okay? Do you have question on the writing on the board? Again, this is a continuous action. A past continuous action. Kasi pasado yung pinag-uusapan natin. Pasado ng verbo estar. Estaba, estabas, estaba, estabamos, estabais, at estaban. Okay? So, ang pinakikita ko lang talaga po dito sa explanation ko na ito, I mean these sentences, I just want to show you the past of verb to be. The simple past of verb to be sa sentence na to. Daw, ang ano natin is continuous action. This is a continuous action. Okay? So, kung gagawin mo yung ano, negative sentence, for example, so magdadagdag ka lang ng no. Yo no estaba. Yo no estaba trabajando. So, ano yan? Magiging I wasn't working. Magdadagdag ka lang ng ano? Negative. I wasn't working. So, ganun lang. Pag gagawin mo siyang negative, yo no estaba trabajando. So, magiging I wasn't working. Tapos yung second person, tú no estabas trabajando. So, you were not or you weren't working. Él no estaba trabajando. Pues, he wasn't working. Nosotros no estaban trabajando. No estaban. So, magdadagdag ka lang ng no before the verb be. No estaban. So, pag tinanslate natin yan, we weren't or we were not working. No estabais trabajando. So, you weren't working. And then, ellos o ellas no estaban trabajando. So, they weren't working. Ganun lang pag sa negative naman na forma, no? Ang ano, pag interrogatibo naman, uunahin mo lang yung verb. Uunahin mo lang yung verb, syempre. So, ganun naman yung pattern natin sa English. If you are going to make a interrogative, then the verb will come first in your sentence. So, I will be showing you how you are going to write como si forman los verbos regulares. Okay? Magawa tayo ng example ng verb that ends with AR, ER, and IR. Termina con AR, ER, and la IR. Kung paano natin iaano yung pagkakaiba nila, okay? Sana ano, sana may naintindihan kayo sa lesson natin today. Gagawa ako nga ng ano, ng pinakasimpleng halimbawa at saka explanation para mas madali pong maintindihan. Okay, AR. Halimbawa, verbo cantar. And then, ER, verbo comer, means to eat. And then, IR, escribir, to write. Patience talaga ang kailangan po kapag nag-aaral ka ng bagong ano, language, tsaka determination, of course. Kasi, ano talaga, tsagaan lang yan eh. Hindi mo yan makukuha sa isang ano lang, yo, kante. Ayan, pansinin nyo ha, yung AR, tsaka ano yung magiging ano po, tapos cantaste, cantaste, canto, third person, canto, cantamos, cantasteis, siyempre cantaron. So, ngayon, si Miss Kath, kahit papano eh, napapag-connect-connect ko ng mga bagay-bagay. Ay, talaga, nakakatuwa naman ni Sidro. Nakakatuwa naman po, maraming salamat ah. Alam nyo, natutuwa ako pag nagko-comment kayo na nakakatulong ang aking ano po, effort na gumawa ng anong tawag dito? Ng tutorial. Kasi, naaaliw kasi ako, nawawala yung pagiging homesick ko ba pag ginagawa ko to. Kaya talaga, excited din ako na nagkaklase ako. Kahit, alam mo yun, minsan, kahit sabi ko, kahit walang manood, okay lang. Basta, ano, may natutulungan ako kahit isa o dalawa man lang. Diba? I mean, I am happy to know that there are few people learning my Spanish tutorial. Okay, so I want you to observe, okay, each verbs. First person, cante, from the word cantar. Ends with AR, cantar. Canta sa ating mga Tagalog, di ba? Sa Filipino word, canta. Sa ating Tagalog, ay sa ating kasi, madali lang sabihin eh, ako ay kumanta, ganon. Ako ay kumanta. O, sa tawag nito, sa pasado, kumanta, di ba? Ay, present ang kumanta. Kumakanta, kakanta. Kumanta, kumakanta, kakanta. Ganun yung pagbabanghay natin, di ba? Sa Tagalog. So, ito naman yung ginagawa sa Spanish word, pagbabanghay. Actually, laking tulong mga vids mo, lalo na sa case ko na di nakakalabas-labas kasi nag-aalaga ng mga kambal kong anak. Oh, you have twins! Tienes gemelos! Que mona! Ang galing naman! Congratulations! For your twins. Ang saya. Sabihin nyo, ang saya. Ano, hindi lahat biniyayaan po ng ganyan. Okay. Cantaste. Ayan ha, from the word cantar. Ang word na cantar, cant, tapos dadagdagan mo lang ng first person ng I con acento, at I. Cantaste, ayan, magdadagdag ka lang ng aste. Canto, el canto. El noche vieja, for example. El canto, el noche vieja. So, cantamos, ayan, magdadagdag ka lang ng amos. Cantasteis, asteis, and then aron, cantaron. Alam nyo, ano to, ganito lang ginagawa ko, sinusulat ko lang siya, tapos nag-iisip ako ng mga verb. Ah, okay, verb nag-ends ng AR. Tapos ano ko na yan, palit-palitin ko na yan, para lang ma-practice ko. So, dun tayo sa ER. So, dito naman, ang word naman ay, wait lang, com. Dun naman tayo sa com. Yeah. Com. Comi. Okay? Comi. Tapos com. Miste. Comiste. Comio. Con acento en la O. Comio. Comimos. Diba sa present, comemos. Sa pasado, comimos. Naging ay siya. Tapos, comisteis. Comisteis. Tapos, comieron. Comieron. Ayan. Verbs that ends with ER. ER. So, ang letter E, mag-change ka into I. Comi. Yo comí pescado anoche, for example. Vale? Comiste. So, ang idadagdag mo dito ay iste. Iste. Comió. I-O. Comió. Tapos, imos. Tapos, isteis at eron. Aaron. Again, Aaron. Okay? So, dito tayo sa IR. Word that ends with ER. Naku, pag sa irregular verb, Diyos ko po, mag-iiba siya ng bunggang-bungga. Escribí. Escribe. Escribe. Escribiste. Escribió. For example, escribió, él escribió una carta para mí. Para mí. Escribió una carta para mí. Escribimos. Escribimos. Escribisteis, escribieron, So, ayan, ano natin? Ang IR, ayan, napansin nyo, AR naging E. E-R-I, I-R-I, tapos iste. Yo, imos, isteis, Aaron. So, yun yung pattern. Pattern, matawag pala tandaan. Pattern, banghay sa ano? Sa ating mga Tagalog, di ba? So, ganito po natin banghayin ang mga verbo po sa Espanyol. So, this is how you are going to make different verbs and different pronouns. The first person, second person, third person. And then, first person plural, second person plural, and third person plural. Ako, ikaw, siya, di ba? Tapos tayo, tapos second person, sila, and then third person, kayo, third person, kayo, o sila, third person pala, sila. Okay? So, yan po yung ano example na regular. Regulares. Pardon. Regulares. Huy, nilalamig na ako. Namatay na yung ano, yung heater. Nilalamig na si Inday. So, ano po, may naintindihan po ba kayo sa ating pong tinalakay today? I mean, if you understand something for our lesson today. Kita niyo yan? Ang dami kong printouts. Ang dami kong printouts. Para sa ano natin. Para sa lesson natin. Hello. Okay. So, ano naman tayo? Irregulares, okay? We are going to make verbo irregulares para makita nyo yung difference at alam nyo na kung paano kayo magbanghay. How you are going to do the the irregular verbs. Irregulares. Verbo irregulares. Mega, mega shout out for the 6,000 in the house. Thanks so much for joining my live streaming. And please do not forget to give me a thumbs up and a comment also. And a comment if you like this video. Madami po. Salamat sa lesson at tips. Thank you po. At na-appreciate niyo po ang aking channel. Okay, ano tayo? Verbo irregulares. para makita nyo yung difference ng regular and irregular. Kasi, naku, ito, Diyos ko, good luck po. Verbo, tener, to have, inano natin to, hacer, to make, or to do, and then, estar. The all-time verb, all-time verb, estar. Naku, tingnan nyo ha, yung pinagkaiba nito. Diyos ko, Lord. Lagay natin yung pronoun para to. Ano na lang ha, L lang ilagay ko, pero alam nyo na yan. El, ella, usted. Nosotros, nosotras, nos. Vosotros, vosotras, vos. Ellos, ellas, ellas, and ustedes. Okay? So, verbo tener. Verbo to have. Okay? For example, tengo. Canal in YouTube. In present yun. I have a YouTube channel. I have. So, kapag pinag-uusapan natin ay pasado, tube. Tube. Layo, no? Tener a tube. Tubiste. Okay? And then, tubo. And then, nosotros tuvimos. And tuvieron. Okay? So, i-underline natin ang pinagkaiba nila. Mega, mega shout out po for the 6,000 in the house. Thank you so much again for joining. If you have any comment, suggestions, opinions about our topic, or if you want to comment anything, whatever you want about my channel, feel free to comment or leave your message in a comment down below, okay? I am very happy to read your comments. Este. Oh. Imos. Estes. Ero. Okay? So, ganyan po natin banghayin ang verbo tener el pasado. So, again, verbo tener, to have. Sa Tagalog, ano yan? Ako ay may ganon, di ba? Ako ay may ganon. Ako ay na ano ko? Napuwin ako. Okay, hacer, to make. Na ano natin to nung nakaraan, di ba? Yung most common verbs natin. Kung hindi nyo po na naabutan ng aking live stream noon, you can watch my live streaming. Hizo. Hicimos. Hicisteis. E hicieron. Okay. Verbo hacer. To make. Hice una tarta de manzana. Hice una tarta de manzana. So, uy, I made. Hice, ¿vale? Histe. Hizo, third person, nakita niyo, nag-iba yung ano, yung spelling. Imos, estéis, and Aaron. Grabe no, ang irregular verbs. Madami po, maestra. Salamat po sa lesson at tips. Oy, thank you, Jovelyn Dagala. At na-appreciate mo ang lesson natin na to. Kasi, ano to, dahil ni-request mo to sa akin, ayan, ginawan ko siya ng ano today. Tsaka sana nakatulong. Daw, ano natin to, preliminary discussion lang natin about past tense. Kasi, Ang inisip ko kasi kapag mag-ano tayo sa pinakamalalim na discussion, hindi nyo agad masyadong maintindihan. Kaya inisip ko kung paano ko siya natutunan, yun yung paraan ko na ituturo sa inyo. Kasi yun yung naging effective sa akin. Again, I am very honest to tell that I am not a Spanish teacher. I am studying the language here in Spain. That is why I am doing this live streaming, to share my studies and my knowledge of learning Spanish language. So, yun po yung aking purpose na ginagawa ko talaga. I really spend time to make tutorials so that I can share my knowledge how I study and understand the Spanish language. Ayun po. Okay, the all-time favorite Esther. Ito na. Ito na. Okay, estuve. For example, estuve un año in Barcelona, for example, no? Verbo estar. Estuve. Estuviste. Estuviste. Estuvo. And then, estuvimos. Uy, gumagalaw na naman ang ating whiteboard. Alam nyo, ipagdasal yun na na lumaki yung channel natin this year. Kasi gusto ko magkaroon ng mini classroom sa ating tutorial. Pero syempre, magagawa lang natin yan kapag lumaki na yung channel natin at meron na tayong budget. Kaya tis-tis muna tayo sa sa maliit na mini board natin. Habang wala pa tayong budget. But God, in God's grace. In God's grace. And of course, if you are there to support my channel, you are watching, you are sharing my videos, and that means a lot to me. Okay. Este. O, imos, estéis, ieron. So, anong napansin nyo sa irregulares, the irregular verbs? Nagbabago po ang mga salita nila. So, yan po ang pinagkaiba ng irregular verbs. So, anong gagawin para madali po nating magamit ito sa mga pangungusap? Kailangan lang i-memorize. Kailangan lang i-memorize kung ano yung mga verbo na to. Kasi kung hindi, wala pong ibang paraan. Parang sa lang yan, in English word also, we have irregular verbs. And what we do, we memorize the irregular verbs in English. Like eat, ate, eaten. Diba? O sit, sit, sit. Sit, sit, sit. Buy, bought. Bot, 'di ba? Ganun yung ginagawa natin, buy bot. Uy, ganun yung ginawa natin sa English. So ganun din yung gagawin natin sa Spanish. Kasi wala namang ibang paraan paano natin ito maintindihan kundi kabisaduhin. Try to understand and memorize all the words, especially in each pronoun you have different verbs. Kaya yun po yung pinagkaiba. Kasi 'di ba sa English ang madali lang, maybe because we studied that from nursery, tinuruan na tayo mag-English sa ating mga Filipino, ha. So that is why English for us is easier if we are going to study into another language. But now, same in English. You read a lot, you listen a lot of English movies, songs, and then try to imitate them, how they pronounce the word, so that you can also pronounce it correctly. And then, after that, what you heard, what you read, try to write it in your own. And then, the last skills, you're going to apply it by speaking. Try to speak the Spanish language. You can, nowadays, it is easier for us to talk with the natives because of the social media. I mean, we have a Facebook page that there are a lot of people who wants to exchange languages. There are English native who wants to study Spanish, and there are Spanish natives who wants to study English. So, same also, there are Filipinos na gusto din matuto. So, pwede tayong makipag-exchange ng language sa kanila. Kaya, mas madali na ngayon ang mag-practice sa atin. Oh, mega-mega shout-out, Giant TV. Thank you for joining my live streaming. Ano, happy holidays, kabayan. Are you not busy today? You're not working today, Giant? Are you still on holiday? Oh my God! Nasulat ko yung ano. Dapat sasapinan ko tong ano. Thank you so much, Giant, for the BG. Mega, mega shout out. Giant TV from the Middle East, who is very supportive friend to me. Okay, do you have any questions about our topic? Thank you for the thumbs up. Thanks a lot for the thumbs up, people of the world. Do you have question about this one? Oh, thank you so much. She is Sydney for joining my live streaming. Mega, mega shout out. Mega, mega shout out, and thank you for joining my live streaming today. Super punas ako. Nasulatan ko yung ano. Okay, so if you don't have any question about our pagbabanghay in irregular verbs, then our last activity, we are going to write sentences, okay? And then after that, we can have our question and answer portion. Wow, Q&A. Siyempre, may Q&A tayo dapat, diba? Sa ating, ano, class discussion para alam natin kung talagang naiintindihan po ng lahat. Dapat nga may quiz pa to is may ganun eh. Okay, so we will write sentences, okay? Just to make sure na meron talaga kayong naiintindihan. Okay, people? Ati Isidro, Ati, muchísimas gracias. Because you are... there, you are supporting my channel, and that means a lot to me. Kung pinanonood niyo po ang ating video, napakalaking tulong na po niyan sa akin. At pag-share niyo po sa mga kaibigan, kapamilya, at kakilala, maraming salamat po. Maraming salamat po. For example, comimos, hablamos del pasado, comimos. Ay, ito, napaka-ano nitong halimbawa na to. Napaka-real nito. Real talk tayo. Real talk tayo dito sa ano ko, sa sentence ko. Okay. Comimos paella todos los domingos en España. This is... Oh! Hola, soy Javier. Muchísimas gracias, Javier, por unirte. Francisco Sanchez. Javier is my student in the academy. Thank you so much, Javier. You are so sweet. Thanks a lot, Javier, for joining. Muchísimas gracias por unirte a mi canal. El de la academia. Ya, ya lo sé. Muchísimas gracias, Javier. Y saludo a mi parte a tu hermano, tu gemelo, a Fran, tu gemelo, Fran. Ok, comimos paella todos los domingos en España. You know what? When I, like for example, before. Gracias, Javier, qué dulce. Ok, so, last 2018, on my first months here in Spain, we are like every, either Saturday or Sunday, no, normally Sunday, we have this paella in the countryside. So, on my first months, it's very impressive. Oh my God! I mean, you can see a big paella. Tapos mga 17 or 20 more people ang kakain. Pero yung kada semana na siya, parang gusto ko ng paella na naman. Parang ganon. Nalala ko sa ano, you know what? Nalala ko dati nung nasa Las Piñas Science kami, laging may nagbibigay sa amin, teachers, ng pansit. So, kapag may papansit yung mga parents, parang every week na pansit na naman. Parang ayaw na namin kumain ng pansit. So, ganun din ako dito nung bago ako dito. Yung every week paella, paella na naman. ¿Qué estás dando? Estoy dando clase de español. Javier, I am teaching Spanish lesson on my live streaming. ¿Es correcto mi frase, Javier? ¿De qué tema? Estamos hablando de indefinido. Indefinido, Javier, we're talking about past tense. Indefinido. Comimos. Okay, yeah, thank you again for the thumbs up and mega, mega shout out for the 8,000 in the house. Muchísimas gracias por unirte. Okay, fuimos, 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 fuimos al parque. Okay, fuimos al parque. De el año pasado. Antes, cuando estaba a yo in mi trabajo, en mi primer mes in la academia, no, Javier, yo no sé nada de español. Y ellos siempre dicen cosas que yo no entiendo, los niños. Pero ahora, y aprendido mucho. Okay, fuimos al parque de atracciones el año pasado. El año pasado. Oh, because it's masculino. So, our article, artículo el año pasado. Si is feminina is la. For example, la semana pasada. So, yan yung ano, dapat nating tandaan po sa Spanish. Napaka-ano nila sa feminino and masculino. Fuimos al parque de atracciones el año pasado. Okay? So, parang ano yan. Our verb is fuimos. Fue. Fue a Alemania el año pasado. Okay? So, question. Sería comemos paella todos los domingos en España. Comemos is el presente, ¿no? Javier, comemos. Y el pasado, comimos. Aquí sí. Comemos is presente. E comimos el pasado. ¿No, Javier? Así, perdón, no pasa nada. Comemos, comemos. Presente. Y de arriba, comimos el pasado de verbo comer. Comemos, presente. Y luego, comimos el pasado. Gracias, Javier. Okay, so do you have any questions about our topic? Do you have question, Javier? Do you want to ask something about English or Spanish or Tagalog? Our language in the Philippines, Tagalog. Mabuhay. Can you see my number of subscribers, Javier? I have now 2,700. It's growing. Ha subido mucho. Okay, so let's have the may ano tawag nito. Napipi na ako. Napipi na ako. I want to take a pee. Okay, so if you have any questions, comments, suggestion, feel free to chat on our live chat. Okay, if you have any comments, suggestions about our topic today, please feel free to message in our chat box. Okay. I am going to write a definition before we are going to so how we are going to use this preterito. Estos son ayan. Estos, verbo, ay verbo,
Oh no.
One moment, please.
Un momento.
Dime, mama. Sí. Vale. ¿Qué? Yo, pues, ¿dónde estás? En casa, pero estoy dando clase en directo, mamá. Vale.
Ay, tumawag yung binan ko. My in-laws. Okay, so, estos son los usos.
These are the uses. These, estos, these. Okay, son, verbo, hacer, are. These are los, article, the, usos is use, how you are going to use this. Okay? Nag-translate ng word by word. Again, nag-translate ng word by word. Okay, el preterito. Isulat ko lang to ha, then we will have our question and answer. Para ano, malinaw na po sa atin. And then we're going to end this. Live streaming today, and I hope that you learned something today. To express actions, acciones terminadas, terminadas, que se en el pasado. Okay. Estos son los usos. El pretérito indefinido se utiliza para expresar acciones terminadas que se repitieron en el pasado. También para hablar. Okay, para hablar sobre acciones terminadas en un momento concreto. Okay, so, también, I'm going to eat. Goodbye. Goodbye, Javier. See you next week or, next week. Thanks so much for joining. Okay, hablar sobre acciones. We are going to talk about action words. Terminadas en un momento concreto del pasado. As in, tapos na talaga siya. Tapos na siya. Okay? So, these are the different how you are going to use these indefinido. So, again, thank you so much for joining me today. And I hope that you learned something today about our topic. So, see you next time. I maybe if I have time tomorrow, I will try to have a quick online tutorial while I am on my vacation. That is why I am trying to do an online tutorial while I am not working. So again, please help me grow my channel by watching. No skip of ads for please. No skipping ads, please. And also, please share it to your family and friends. And I hope that this video you are going to learn something. Okay, so ayan po. See you next time again, and God bless you all. Bye! Hasta luego! Thanks so much for joining my live streaming. God bless us, everyone. Bye-bye.